Hello everyone, welcome to a new video of the Indicator Store of the series Do It Yourself. Today we are going to review how to create a counter with Builder. As we saw on previous videos, it is very useful to have a counter because sometimes we need to count the number of bars between two different events or the number of trades on a certain day, or for example to have an event, for example here where we have a red bar followed by a green bar, and then at this moment I want to place a buy limit below the market and I want that order to be pending for a certain number of bars, but on the following bars the condition is no longer true because it is only true when it is red and then green. So for example, if I want to enter on a pullback, the pullback only happens here on the bar number 16, 17, 19, more or less. So how can I place, how can I check the condition and then start counting bar, because the condition is no longer true on the remaining bars. There are two different events. Event number one, when there is a red bar followed by a green bar, then I am looking for a long. And then the event number two is if I want to enter long, then if the bar number is no longer than a certain number, then I place a limit entry order until I get a fill or the counter exceeds the number I set. As we saw, it is a little complicated to do this on Builder. Let's view an example. Let's say we want to create exactly this, a counter where everybody's green. So here we have a Builder. Let's create a new strategy. The name for the strategy with counter. We are going to work at our close. And we saw that we need to create a variable, the variable for the counter. By now, we don't need input parameters. Just detect the pattern and then add one to the current counter. And when the bar is red, I reset the counter. So the usual, the easiest way will be to create a variable, for example, counter. We can set this variable to integer without decimals because the number of bar don't have decimals. And we start with zero. Then, on the conditions, if the bar is green, I add one to the counter. If the bar is red, I set the counter to zero. So let's start by the condition to reset, when the bar is red. If the bar is red, that means that the close is less or equal than the open. Like this. In that case, we set the counter to zero. So we go to miscellaneous, set the variable name that we defined, and then we can set zero. So everything is okay, no problem. Now, if the bar is green, the condition is similar to this one, but inverted. The close is greater than the open. So price close greater open. And in that case, I want counter equal to counter plus one. So usually we go to miscellaneous, set counter equal to the variable counter, and it should be wonderful that we have an offset here so we can set plus one. That option is everywhere. Like when we set an indicator, they have an offset. The offset is present everywhere but on the user variables, so we cannot add one. Even if I type a plus one here, this is ignored. Everything that we type here is removed. So we get counter equal counter. But we saw on previous videos that it is easy to unlock the code, and then on the resulting code, we only need to look for the place where we place counter equal counter, and then add a plus one and compile again. The problem is that once you open the code, there's no way to come back to Builder because the code is open now. There was a partial solution where we had a builder version, then a copy open where we add the missing changes. But now let's check another way to create everything from builder. Instead of a variable, we go back to the previous screen. The first option is to after the bar close. We have an option to add a second time frame. And below, we have custom series. A custom series is where we add arrays. So we set the number of the variable. I am not going to use counter because it is already used by the variable. And the same, we also set an integer. What's the difference between a variable and a custom series or vector? The difference is that it has a value on each bar. So when we refer to that variable, we need to specify between brackets the number of bar. Now, this is no longer used, so we can replace all counters. We can remove this. And also on the first tab. So when the bar is red, we reset the new counter. So we click on Add, on Miscellaneous, set the new counter equal to zero. And we can see that the brackets are here with a zero in the middle because we can set which bar value we want to change. The variable has a different value on each bar. The interesting on about using a vector or an array is that now we can add an offset. So we go to miscellaneous, set counter, the new counter, equal to. And here we don't have on user variables the array or the vector, but on miscellaneous we have custom series. And on custom series, all the series that we have defined at the beginning. And here we have the offset. So we can add a plus one. But on which bar? Not on the current bar. I want to add one to the previous bar, to the value of the variable on the previous bar. So the value of the counter on the previous bar, I add one. And this is how it looks. Counter on current bar is equal to the counter on the previous bar plus one. Let's draw the value with the text on drawing a text object. The tag is the name of the object. The object must be different on each bar, so we can get a different object painted. So for the tag name, let's add the current bar, something that changes each bar. So on miscellaneous current bar. Okay. So the name of the object is text2 followed by current bar. And the text that I want to print is the value of the variable. So set on miscellaneous custom series. The name that we just defined on the current bar, not adding nothing. And which vertical position? I want at the top of the bar, high, plus 1 point. So here we place price high plus 1 point, and we can compile and let's see how it looks. Now we add the new strategy. Wizard counter, whiz counter. There are no parameters. And this is how it looks. It adds a number. It is counting green bars and placing the value at the top of the bar. Each time the bar is green, it adds 1 to the previous value. When the bar is red, the value is 0, but it is not shown, because here I am only setting to 0 the value. If I want to also paint the value, I can copy the draw text from the other condition. So now we can refresh or enable and disable the strategy. And now we have the values at the red bars also. Because the bar is red, the counter is set to 0 each time. And when the bar is green, it adds 1 to the previous bar. And now we can use this as a counter for anything. So, which is the trick? Instead of using a variable, the variables are defined below the input parameters. Now we don't need a variable. But what we need is a custom series, a vector, an array. Okay, don't forget that we have a training session about NinjaScript all weeks. For more information, go to the chat room. We have a chat room on Discord. The instructions are on the description of this video. You can always find me on the chat room. Thank you, everyone. Bye bye.